But of course, if she looks like causing trouble, I'll fix her, no worries. And she'll have no one to blame but herself.
Mrs. Reynolds, the way I feel right now, I haven't got enough energy to lift me little finger.
We'll give your body a chance. You've had a lot of tests done today. We'll have the results by the end of the week, then we'll know what's going on.
She's sweet. Fred's okay.
There's a woman called Lisa Mullins.
Give you the old heave-ho, did
look, she? If you're not interested, I'll go and see someone who is.
All right, I'm listening.
Save your speeches. Sick of them and I'm sick of you.
The feeling is mutual.
And I don't even want your job anymore.
Miss Ferguson, this has gone
You far. Know that Connors is as guilty as Simpson. She's been nothing but trouble since she got here. Now suddenly she can do no wrong.
I have perfectly valid reasons for my decisions.
Does your barkeep boyfriend have anything to do with them? Sorry. I should have said your ex-bikey boyfriend.
Anne Reynolds, someone phoned through and I missed it. Was it an outside call? In future, give me time to get to my office, will you? You knew I was on my way. That bloody woman, honestly.
No, you won't. Governors aren't allowed.
Sorry, Mick. How are you? Better than me, I hope.
Well, that wouldn't be too hard. Still Joan, I take it.
Who else? I hope you didn't mind me phoning last night. I had to talk to someone.
No, not at all. I wasn't having a very good night myself.
I'm sure she just did it to get a reaction. You should have seen her face after that remark about Dan.
No, don't go on about it. You'll only upset yourself. Just don't let her win.
She already has. I hit her. I just thank God no one saw it.
Of course. But be careful. She'll keep goading you until you do it in front of a witness. Now, are we going to continue to talk about Joan and ruin our day, or can I tell you about Connors?
Sorry. What did the doctor say?
Well, not very much, but he thinks it's safe for her to go back to light duties. But until the path report comes in, he's not prepared to commit himself.
All right, light duties it is. Might be a good time to put her in the reward cell.
Well, if you think Joan's about to cause trouble, don't you think it'd be better to wait until Rita was back at full strength?
Of course. Honestly, I don't know what's the matter with me today.
Well, why don't you have a cuppa and start again?
Good idea. I've already picked the couple to go in the reward cell next anyway. What do you think?
Really?
Thought I'd get that reaction. Oh, Pat, could you organise a pot of tea, please?
Don't bother telling me I'm late, I already know.
That's what I think it is. I'm surprised we bothered to turn up.
Tape recorder for Tucker. Better check it, though. I don't want to be accused of breaking Reynolds' rules.
Oh, it'll be quite a day. First the governor and now you. Why can't people be more pleasant, like me?
What have you got to be so happy about?
Projects, Mr. Adams. Always have one up your sleeve. It helps relieve the boredom of this place.
Projects, I'm not with you.
Well, let's just say I'm expecting some rather strange behaviour from our normally peaceful, passive governor. Oh, you'll know it when you see it. Just make sure you're around whenever I'm with Reynolds.
Yeah, sure.
I take it you met Bob last night?
I did.
And?
I doubt that Lisa Mullins is going to be a problem for very much longer.
There you are, Mr. Adams. See, you have a project, and already you've got a smile on your face.
Oh, Mr. Adams, did you know the governor's looking for you?
No, what's she want?
I don't know, but I wouldn't keep her waiting if I were you.
Six dozen towels? That's pushing it a bit, isn't it?
Yes, well, I may as well be cheeky while Dwyer's been kind to me. That's the end of the paperwork, isn't it? Please say yes. I'm sick of it.
Yes. Now, mind if I ask you a question?
I know. Why am I putting McPherson and Tucker in the reward cell, right?
You must admit it does seem a bit strange, especially after Brumby's just got out of the punishment cell.
So what better time to let her see what she might be missing out on in the future?
Yes, I suppose I can see it that way. But what about Vicky? I mean, she and Brumby are like cat and dog.
Well, they certainly have been in the past. But I blame Spider Simpson for that.
And now that Spider's gone, of course.
Don't tell me I've done something right for a change.
You are back on the payroll.
You wanted to see me, Mrs. Reynolds.
Yes, Rodney, come in. Is that the tape recorder?
It is, and I'd like to go on record that I'm doing this under protest.
Understood.
And if you don't mind, I'd rather not be around when you give it to her.
I'm afraid that won't be possible. Is that the bill for the second sitting, Mrs. Reynolds?
Yes, they should be settled in about 5 minutes.
Good. I want you to take that to the dining room and give it to Tucker.
No.
Mr. Adams.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Reynolds, but this has gone far enough, and I'm not going to do it.
Well, what is it?
If you can read, it's a tape recorder.
So?
I'm replacing the one I broke. It's yours.
Well, is it the same sort?
Why don't you open it and find out, Tucker?
Careful, Brummy might have booby-trapped it.
A little louder, Jenkins. I didn't hear that.
Oh, nothing, Mrs. Reynolds.
Yes, it was. Something about a booby trap?
Oh, it was just a joke, you know.
No, I don't know. Mr. Adams has paid for this out of his own pocket.
Yeah, well, he broke mine, so he had to.
You're wrong, Tucker. Officially, the department's responsible. But Mr. Adams insisted on paying for it this way to show his goodwill. If you want my opinion, I think he's being very generous, especially after the way you treated him yesterday.
It's only a joke.
All right, Alice. I accept that. But I am fighting very hard to bring new ideas and reforms into Wentworth, and I will not have it ruined just because of one of your jokes going wrong and causing trouble. Do you understand?
Yeah. Yes, Mrs. Reynolds.
Good.
I think you've just been crossed off the Christmas card, isn't it?
Yeah, very funny. Thanks for sticking up for me, team.
Oh, no way.
She was great, wasn't she, Ree?
Are you all right?
Yeah, terrific.
How do you think it went?
Well, it's hard to tell with kids like Tucker. I mean, she should have been more than happy with that new recorder. But if she is, we'll never know about it.
Would have been easy enough for her to say thank you.
Oh, dear, no. Would have ruined the image.
Mrs. Reynolds. That business about the department being responsible for the tape recorder. Is it true?
Yes, why?
I see. If that's the case, I want to put in a formal complaint. That thing cost me a lot of money. I can't afford to buy things for prisoners.
You can't afford not to buy, Mr. Adams.
Oh, come on.
What you did could have caused a lot of trouble for the entire staff. It was very unprofessional of you, Rodney.
If you want to go by the book, I'll make out a report naming you as the officer who destroyed a prisoner's property.
Oh, look, all I'm saying
or
is
you
I
can do it my way and hope the women call it quits. Now, what's it to be?
Just forget it. I'm always in the wrong anyway. Yeah.
It's Terry, everything okay?
Hang on, I'll check. Okay, what's on?
She been giving you any more trouble?
No, she's been very quiet, too quiet. I think she might have heard us talking last night. Have you had a word to Rom yet?
Yeah, he wants her dead.
Yeah? Well, I never really thought he'd be able to get her out of the country anyway. Who's going to do it?
You are. He thinks a lot of you, man.
No, hang on. I mean, if he wants her killed, well, look, I'm no trigger man.
Ron reckons it's worth $7,000 to you.
A million wouldn't be enough, Terry. You know me. Come on, it's not on.
It was worth a try. Look, I'll be up there as soon as possible.
Good.
No, don't.
Please.
Shut up. Shut up and sit down.
Please, Matt, you're not thinking. Shh! Let me go. I won't say anything. What would be the point? If I get caught, I'll go back to jail anyway.
Look, Ron Willis wants you dead, and he's a dangerous man. I'm certainly not going to cross.
He's only dangerous because he's got people like you to do his dirty work for him.
Well, at least he employs me, Maxwell. People are funny when it comes to employing me. Or perhaps it's because I'm too old. 36. What do you reckon, Maxwell? Do you think that's the reason, eh?
No. And it isn't because you're blind either. It's because you've got a criminal record. Like me, we haven't got a chance.
Oh, it's birds of a feather now, is it? Comrades in arms. Well, you won't get away with it, Maxwell. It might be some consolation for you to know that Terry's a very good shot. Sit down. Maxwell.
If everyone would just keep quiet, I might be able to work out the new duty roster.
Quiet.
Hey, Mr. Adams, how do you make this thing play? It's different than the other one.
Don't you mean better?
Yeah, I suppose it is. But you really shouldn't have spent all that dough.
Shut up, Brumby.
You give it a rest, okay?
Like hell. It's still us against them as far as I'm concerned.
Not for Connors it isn't. She gets her own mate, Shanghai.
Spider was no mate of mine.
Spider didn't have any mates. Anyway, they're nothing to do with Reet.
Yeah, well, I don't care who done it. Spider was a nerd. good riddance, I reckon.
Don't you be too sure of yourself. I'd have still been in the reward cell if it hadn't been for you.
Oh, come off it. Martha was driving you up the wall, and you said so yourself.
All right, everyone. Quiet.
Sorry, ladies. I forgot to tell Mrs. Morris about some changes in the work roster.
Oh, yes. Connors and Jenkins are the only ones I can't find.
We thought we were getting a holiday for good behaviour.
Almost. I'm putting Rita on light cleaning duties till she gets her strength back. And I want you to stay with her, Alice.
Sure.
Have you told McPherson and Tucker?
Eyes up, what have we done now?
Made prison history, I should think. The only inmate to spend one night in the punishment cell and the next in the reward cell.
You for real?
I hasten to add it's got nothing to do with you earning reward points. Before the point system starts, I want as many of you as possible to see what you can achieve.
Well, don't tell me I have to share with her.
You'll have to do better than that, Vicky. You'll have to make it work. Which means putting all your differences aside and working together, do you understand?
Oh, yeah. Sounds like one of those animal experiments I was complaining about on the telly.
I'll also be dropping into your work areas during the day, so if any of you have got any problems you want to discuss, just let me know.
Can you tell me what time, and I'll arrange an escort for you?
No escort, Mrs. Morris. I'll be doing the tours alone.
Sit here. Come on, will you, Matt?
Yeah, look, I'm okay. I'm sorry.
Was she alone?
Yeah, but my gun. Has she got my gun?
It's here. I'm going after her. You gonna be okay?
Yeah, just get her. But she wouldn't have gone for the road because she knew you were coming. West. Try going west.
Confident, Tucker. You'll be out of here in 2 hours.
Don't bet on it. Hey, go easy with the recorder. Those things cost money.
You're really asking for trouble, aren't you?
I just don't want to get anything broken. Hey, I wonder if it's the same as Lisa's.
Well, she'll be back soon enough, so maybe you could ask her.
Which bedroom do you want?
Who cares? Listen, Tucker, you want to play house, okay, but leave me out of it.
Yeah, all right. I don't like you either. But we might as well enjoy it.
What's to enjoy? We've even got to cook our own meals.
Hey, they've even got a fridge. Oh, bloody hell, everything's defrosted.
Oh, don't be a wagger, they're fresh.
They're defrosted. Bloody fridges aren't working.
There's nothing wrong with the fridge. Truth, haven't you seen fresh veggies before?
Yeah, in a freezer in the supermarket. What do you think I am, stupid?
I give up. I'll take this bedroom.
You know, all this would be okay if it wasn't for this. I mean, how much fun can we have if they're going to stick some poor bugger in next door?
As long as it's Connors, I'll be real happy.
Now, keep yourself nice. Now, where's this door we can get outside?
Out the door, turn right, then right again.
Gotcha!
Well, you better put your stuff away.
This isn't gonna work.
Reno said you're supposed to be on light duties, not breaking bloody rocks.
I heard her. Everyone bloody heard her.
So?
So why couldn't you keep her big mouth shut?
She's worried about you, Reet.
Bull.
All right, I'm worried about you. You look bloody awful.
Yeah, well, I hate to tell you this, Lurch, but you're not going to win no beauty contest neither.
You quit mucking around. You know what I mean.
Look, I've got the flu or something. It's not the end of the world. I'm not the first person in the world to get it.
Will you just slow down for a minute?
Oh, you slow down. I'm going to get some more water.
She'll be all right now, Mr. Jackson. Go in whenever you like.
Just a minute. What have you done to her?
What? Oh, this. Nothing to worry about, sir. just as much for her protection as anything else.
But I know her. There's no
nothing to do with your visit, Mr. Jackson. She's been on 4 hourly sedation since she arrived here.
Mal? Mel, they've gone. It's me, Marty, Mr. Jackson. It's all right. It's all right.
Take me home. Take me home.
Just yet, Mel. I can't. You get better. And I'll
take won't it. Do it again. I was bad, but I won't do it again.
We know you weren't bad. Just follow Kat.
She isn't my friend. I hate her. I hate Kat. She lied and I hate her.
Why don't you come sit on the chair?
Take me home. Take me home. I'll tell everybody.
I need you.
I'm sorry. I'll tell them. Mom, I'll tell them I'm sorry. Tell them.
Look at me. Some bad people are trying to hurt me and Margaret. Spike. You remember Spike?
I don't have anything to spite. Kat made me give her a chockey and made her sick, and Kat's not a very nice person.
What was wrong with the chockey?
I thought she was my friend and she's not a very nice person.
What else did Kat do?
Kat said, give the chocolate to Spike. Merle, don't give it to anyone else. And it made Spike sick.
Listen.
And she left me.
No. Well, please listen to me.
Take me home. Take me. Take me home.
Where do you reckon you're going?
No. Kill me and your brother goes to jail.
Nice try.
If I don't get to see my friend, you'll all go, Willis included. She knows everything.
You're lying. Just buying time.
Then why don't you pull the trigger?
Sorry, Mr. Jackson. She has to wake up anyway. It's time for her tests.
Please, can I wake her? Sorry, what's your name?
Marshall. Graham Marshall.
Please, Graham. Just a couple of minutes and I'll give you a call.
I'm sorry, Mr. Jackson.
I promise you. 2 minutes, that's all I want.
If Dr. Galbraith finds out.
Graham, one other favor. Could you give her this when you come in, please? Mo, wake up. Wake up. Come on, wake up. Awake? Hey, don't go back to sleep again. I've got to go home.
No!
I've got to go sometime. And you want me to come back, don't you? Well, if I don't leave and all the other visitors leave, they might let me. And how can I tell Mrs. Reynolds that you're sorry if I don't go and see her? Come on. Come and sit up on the bed.
I don't think I can get up. I still feel funny after the needle.
Come on. Oh, my legs nearly went to sleep. Graham, have you got a minute? Now, Mr. Marshall's your friend too. He wants to help you.
Of course I do. He even brought you a present, Miss Jones.
Thank you, Mr. Jackson.
Now, I'll come and visit you again. Goodbye, ma'am.
It's okay, it's me. You're right, she was headed towards the Patterson place.
Well, why'd you bring her back?
I had to. Did you say anything to you about Jones? The one who was supposed to...
Oh, yes, sorry. Yeah, I'm with you now. No, only what I told you she said about wanting to get in touch with the hospital all the time. She seemed pretty determined about that.
If I don't speak to her, the police will go straight to Ron Willis. She'll tell them everything.
Matt, I doubt it. The radio report said she was a half-wit.
That's rubbish. They were just looking for a good story. She's as sane as any of us.
Okay, what if I believe you? I mean, what does she know? What is she going to go to the cops with?
The dope plant on Jackson and Spike Marsh. Why you did it, the escape, Ron Willis's name.
No, I doubt it. She's a psycho. Why would you tell her all that?
It's called insurance. If I hadn't contacted her within 48 hours, she was to tell the police everything. I'm her only friend, you see. She does exactly as I tell her.
What do you reckon?
I don't know. Put her in the other room. I'll ring Ron.
Hi, Kay, so what are we supposed to do with it?
How the hell would I know?
Can't you think of something? I'm bloody starving. What am I, the bloody maid or something? No, but you've done more kitchen duty than I have. Can't you remember what Mervyn does?
Yeah.
Well, go on then. You want me to cook for 70 women? Can't we chuck a chop under the griller or something?
We'd have nothing for tea. Like, but I'm having a cheese sandwich.
Oh, you've got no imagination, Mecca.
All right, genius. What are you having?
I don't know. I'll find out when I get there.
You're not going to the dining room.
Well, sure. Why bark when you own a dog? I think I'll go and have another look at the garden till the bell goes.
Oh, yeah? Why? Haven't you worked it out yet?
What are you talking about?
Well, knock it off, Tucker. I know what you're doing. You reckon you're going to break out again, don't you?
Well, yeah. Well, not this time, but next time I'm in here, I'm off. I'm just using this visit to work it out. Well, you'll be laughing on the other side of your face, McPherson. You'll bloody see.
Just leave it alone, will ya? Bloody hell, we're inside. What do you think? I'm going to climb a fence or something?
Welcome back, Mullins. The place was getting very dull without you.
You want the cuffs left on?
Oh, I don't think so. You are going to behave, aren't you, Mullins? No, you've been a busy girl.
Like hell, I was set up.
Oh, yes, of course.
I was. I never saw the bastard before in my life.
Oh, they all say that. Makes you wonder where the real crims are, doesn't it?
Okay, if I wash my hands, we had a little accident.
Sure. Get on the line, Mullins. Your name is Lisa Marie Mullins, is that correct? Is that correct?
Yes, it's bloody correct.
I don't believe it.
It's a sideshow or something. You've finished.
Perhaps you'd like to take over, Mr. Adams, just up to the charge.
You've been charged and found guilty of assault, occasioning actual bodily harm, and theft, and sentenced to 2 months' imprisonment. Poor old Bob, hope you didn't hurt him too much.
You stupid...
You have the routine, Mullins. It's the hall shower. Sooner you do it, sooner you boot him, mate.
I'm sorry, you're too early for visiting hours. You'd have to come back.
No, I'm not here on a visit. I want to see the governor.
Oh, right to the top, eh? Well, you can't see her without an appointment.
I got one.
You're not serious.
Lady, the only thing I'm not is patient. Now, will you take me to see the governor, or do I find my own way? And, of course, I'll need a set of keys to move around the place.
No, just hold on a minute.
I don't want to dag around trying to find officers to open gates every time I need to get from A to B.
We don't bend security on the grounds of inconvenience, Mr. Lucas.
Tom, and I don't want to be asking officers for help in front of the women.
I don't think you quite...
That'll blow my credibility to hell.
I can't give that sort of license to any ancillary staff.
What do you think I am? I'm not a bloody cleaner, you know.
I'm not implying any distrust.
I damn well hope not. I've had a full security check.
That's not the point. Our security system...
I know the system. I've done the corrective services training course.
Will you let me finish what I'm trying to say, Mr. Lucas?
Tom.
The fact is you are not an inducted officer. You are only a teacher.
There's a lot more to this than only teaching, you know. This is a highly structured program of rehabilitation.
Good. That's what we need.
Yeah. That's what they all say till they get hit with what it means.
I think we'll be able to cope.
Don't count on it. Gets pretty off the wall at times.
As long as it gets results.
It will, if you give it a chance.
You wouldn't be here if I weren't prepared to.
Okay. How about the keys, then?
The trouble with you girls is you can't leave it alone, can you?
I never laid eyes on that chick and you bloody know it.
Oh, according to him, you laid more than eyes on him.
Oh, you're going to get yours, Roddy. You're as big a liar as he is. I'm not going to forget this. You were real stupid telling me.
And what are you going to do?
Load of bull.
I don't think anyone's going to believe that, do you? You went back on the game, rolled a client, pinched his wallet. Sounds just like the sort of thing you'd do to me.
Oh, you think you got it all worked out, don't you?
It fits your record.
How much did you pay him?
Nothing. He owed a friend of mine a favour.
Well, enjoy it while you can, Roddy. Because I've got a feeling it's all going to come unstuck.
Oh, I doubt it. Police believed it. Magistrate believed it.
Yeah. Well, let's see what Reno thinks, will we?
I don't think the governor's silly enough to buy that, do you? You haven't got a snowball's chance in hell of connecting me to this.
Could you wait in the staff room? I'll introduce you to the women as soon as I've seen to this. Right, come in. I'm sorry to see you back here so soon, Mullins.
Hello again. Is this where I found the coffee?
How the hell did you get in here? Where'd you get those?
Governor. You see, now that's what happens when you go right to the top. They don't give you nearly as much hassle as the middle ranks.
You've got no right to free access.
No? Yes. You'd be a rules person, wouldn't you?
They're there for a good reason.
Try Corrective Services Act 1957, paragraph 4, clause C. Permanent staff access to corrective institutions.
Permanent? You won't last a week here.
Probably not. If past experience is anything to go by.
Where else have you been?
Oh, Blackmore, Broadfield, around.
I can just imagine. How long did you last at any of them?
About 5 minutes. They seemed to feel I had an attitude problem.
Oh, I can believe that. You won't find things any different here, either.
Oh, I don't know. Reynolds strikes me as a cut above the average.
The average what? You're all fools. What on earth do you think you can teach the dregs in here?
Reading, writing, adding up, basic office skills. Anything and everything that might get them a job and prove their self-esteem. You know, that sort of garbage.
If they had the brains to learn anything, they wouldn't be in here, would they?
Maybe.
You're wasting your time.
Yeah, well, that's the trouble with us bleeding hearts. We never know when to give up.
You know I can't give any credence to unsupported allegations.
Of course I bloody know, but I'm going to tell you anyway, Mrs. Reynolds.
It's ridiculous. How could I possibly have anything to do with
you
that?
You out there in the corridor and you told
that's
me a loud
enough.
Little...
She'd say anything to get back
that's
at
both
me.
Both of you. It's pointless pursuing this one way or the other. Unless you have something substantial to back the allegation, I'll have to discount it.
Yes, Mrs. Reynolds.
And I suggest you do the same.
Oh, look, how the hell can I when I
make the effort? I think you'll find things have changed a little in your absence. The women have rather more freedom and less supervision. In return, I expect greater responsibility from you all. But there are incentives for those who make the effort.
Yes, Mrs. Reynolds.
I'm sure the other women will fill you in. But I don't think they'll welcome any disruption to the way things are going.
No, Mrs. Reynolds.
Now, wait outside in the corridor for a moment. Mr. Adams will take you back shortly. Problem with Mullins.
It's complete nonsense. I had nothing to do with it.
I'm not questioning you. I have no grounds to.
Sheer malice, I guess.
Whatever prompted it, I think it'd be a very good idea if you kept your distance from her. I don't want any further feuding.
Well, naturally, I wouldn't allow myself to
be put
in that.
Let's leave it, shall we?
Of course, Governor.
Oh, I want to see the women in half an hour. Would you let the other officers know? Get everyone together in the gym?
Yes, Governor.
That'll be all.
Now, just put it on the table and stay away from the door.
What's the point of
just do it. And no more smart ideas, all right?
I'm hardly likely to with Terry prowling around outside.
Well, you should be hoping like hell that no one saw you making a run for it, because he'll have to dump you if they did.
Who's going to see anything going on up here?
Answer me. And use your head.
Hello. Yes, it's Ron Willis.
Give it to me. On the floor.
What?
On the floor with your head down. Move. I said with your head down.
It is.
Look, I can hear a bloody mouse breathing. I know when someone's looking in my direction. Put your head to the floor. Talk to me.
Look, this is...
That's enough.
Crazy.
Yes. Oh, he's just gone out for a while. He shouldn't be long. So we're off the hook, are we? Yeah. Yeah, I'll let him know as soon as he gets back. Yeah. Up.
What did he say? What's happening?
You're full of bull, lady. He checked out your girlfriend.
Merle?
Yeah. She's a half-wit. And a retard wouldn't know what time of day it is.
Well, is she all right? Tell me what's wrong.
It's me coming in.
Terry, help! Terry, help me!
Has she got it?
She's got it. Stay where you are.
Get out of the way! Where are the car keys? Don't try anything. I'll use this.
Get down! I don't think you know how to, love.
Terry.
I know. Just give me the gun before you shoot yourself in the foot.
Terry! What's happening? Terry!
You've got to get up.
But he needs help.
He's dead.
I can't lift him on my own.
Leave him. I've still got the gun.
We've got to ring an ambulance.
No. I want my things. Where are they?
What things?
Clothes, wig, makeup, whatever I was getting on the plane.
Why, where are you going?
To get out of here. Now.
But what about me?
You'll be all right. Just get me the things and you'll be all right.
All right, ladies, come on, move along.
Hey, g'day. Where did you get back?
G'day, Rick. Coming with the first intake. What's that?
Don't tell me you broke probation.
No, I bloody didn't. You asked that little creep.
What's he got to do with it?
Set me up, that's all.
Not because of the photos.
Oh, gee, sorry, Lise. We shouldn't ask you to do it.
You couldn't set up a tea party. How'd you do it?
I don't know. First thing I know, the cops come round charging with soliciting. Reckon the customer said I'd done him over.
Had you?
No way! I was steering clear of that. I never seen him before in my life. Bastard reckons I pinched his wallet and rolled him downstairs.
But they took some tricks word for it.
No, they found his wallet in my flat.
You sure you haven't seen him before?
Oh, come, give me a break, Reed. I'd never seen him before. I've known that. They planted it there.
Well, how'd you know it was Roddy that done it?
The lousy little rat told me. He told me.
Oh, he wasn't big, Knighton.
No, the freak's in on it too.
I wouldn't have asked you to do it if I thought we'd have been dropping you in it.
It's okay. Only a couple of months, no harm done.
Yeah, what about your probation?
Yeah, I don't know. I reckon it could be worse. The conviction means I breached it.
How long?
Don't know. I still got to face that. I'm in front of the same judge. I'm always going to be really impressed with me.
Well, what are we doing down here anyway?
Oh, I don't know. Brenna wants to see us, doesn't she?
Yeah, what about anyone heard?
Search me.
Be that teacher.
What? How'd you know?
Saw him in reception when I come in. And he's in Reno's office too.
What's going on now? Are we going back to school or something?
No bloody way, not me.
Might be all right, could be something to do.
Oh, yeah, you'd reckon. You've had a head start.
Well, I'm not making a deal of myself. Yeah.
Hey, what's he like?
Not like any teacher I've ever seen, believe me.
Look, you just can't leave me here.
I have to.
Look, you'll never get back into that hospital on your own. You won't have a chance.
I'll find a way around it.
Look, they'll just be waiting for you. You can't go back now. It's too late.
I promised her.
Well, perhaps I could help you if you took me with you.
No.
Well, how long do you think you're going to last? I mean, Ron will be out looking for you. You're as good as dead.
I've been as good as dead ever since you got me out. You never were going to get us out of the country, were you? If Merle hadn't been left behind, we'd both be buried out there somewhere by now.
No, I swear it's nothing like that.
You've only been holding off in case you needed me to reach her. I'm not entirely stupid. I've had plenty of time to work it out.
It could be weeks before someone finds me here.
I'm sure your friend Willis won't wait that long to find out what's happened to both of you.
Look, please. I could help you. You need me.
Not anymore.
Terry!
The courses will be posted up as soon as Mr. Lucas has worked out the curriculum, so you'll have time to think it over before enrolling.
So it's spunky, don't you reckon?
For the time being,
gotta be joking. He's fucking Darrow.
Oh, he's all right. He's not as well set up as Harry.
Interested, of course.
You've got yours so
late. I appreciate as much support from you all as possible. In the meantime, I'm sure Mr. Lucas will be happy to answer any questions.
Thanks, Mrs. Reynolds. Could I have a few minutes with the women?
Yes. You'll be outside.
Okay. Well, the deal is, you give me an even break, and I'll do the same for you. You don't have to be smart to learn. You just got to want it and put the work in. So you want to go places? I'll help you get there. You want to buggerize around and kill time? I don't want to know about that. Fair enough?
What makes you think anyone would want to turn up?
You better ask Reed.
You'd be Connors, right?
So you've heard about me already?
No, read your file.
Well, then you'd know the lot, then.
Doesn't tell me a bloody thing.
What do you want to know?
I want to know if this is a fair deal or not.
Well, I'll have to think about it.
That could take forever.
Yeah, it just might.
Be quicker if we toss for it.
Why don't you Indian wrestle him for it, right?
I've got to be a foot taller than him. It wouldn't be fair.
Yeah, but I'm a man.
Oh, you think that makes a difference?
Even the odds a little.
Go on, Reet.
Not even enough.
You, pump iron?
Now and then. Are you?
And none too.
Bench press?
110 kilos.
Oh, jeez, are you sure you want to go through with this?
You sure I'm not lying to you?
Come on, Reet, you'll kill him.
Yeah, Beauty, let's go! Keep it down, girls. You don't want any interruptions.
I don't reckon you order, not when you're being crook.
Get off the bridge. There's nothing wrong with me.
I don't believe that new teacher. It's pathetic. Now she's left him alone with them.
It should be an interesting experience for him.
And he's got his own set of keys.
Look, if the governor wants to take on some pseudo-left-wing intellectual who looks like a refugee from St. Vincent de Paul, that's her problem.
Well, can't we do something about it?
Why bother? They'll eat him for breakfast.
Yes, but...
we've got more important things to do.
We have?
Look, you have got what you wanted. Mullins is back where she belongs.
Yes.
And there are a few things now that I want.
Look, I don't know
how
useful
I can... We have an agreement, Adams, remember?
Yes, I know that, but the governor's
been... But nothing. Now, I sorted Mullins out for you. You couldn't have set that up on your own if your life depended on it.
I realise that, and I do appreciate it.
Yes, and you're going to show that appreciation,
look,
aren't you?
Look, I don't see what I can do with Mrs. Reynolds breathing down my neck. She gave me a definite warning.
Warning? What use is that? There's not a damn thing she can do if there's nothing to act on. And I have no intention of letting those animals get away with what they did to me. Now, they got to Beecham, and I can't get a job anywhere in this state. And that is something they are going to regret for the rest of their days.
But if I'm being watched
don't
all the time...
Don't disappoint me, Adams. You need me more than I need you.
This is killing me.
Well, do you want to take a quick look?
No. I said he could have a free hand to do things his own way, and he can start by breaking the contract.
Well, it doesn't sound like anything to worry about. Sounds more like a party.
Don't say that.
Well, I quite like him. I mean, he looks a bit like a gypsy.
I like what he was saying. You're not really worried about him, are you?
Me? Yes.
Why?
His ideas are fine. It's how he's likely to carry them out that worries me. If that's not trouble on two legs, I'll eat my hat.
There's 10.
140, you were bloody lying.
I wasn't, you know. I've never done that much before.
Well, come on, Rich, show him what you can really do.
Yeah, 150 or plus.
Can't read.
One.
Come on. Two.
She's, I told you so, she's crook.
What?
She's been crook for a couple of weeks.
I'm okay.
Bull you are.
What's the problem?
Nothing.
Yeah, we can see that.
She nearly passed out in the showers this morning.
Oh, you idiot. Why didn't you tell me? You're in no shape to be doing this.
I made 130, didn't I?
Yeah, I'd hate to see what you could do if you were fit.
What's going on?
Well, we decided to start with a gym class. Although one of us forgot to mention she ought to be in sick bay.
Yeah, you all right?
Yeah, Mrs. Morris, I'm fine.
No, she's not. She should have gone to see Sister Hall this morning.
Well, she'd better go and see her now.
Look, there's nothing wrong
with
me.
Will you stop arguing and just go?
All right, ladies, come on, back to work. Quick, move out. A lot of you, quickly.
Get your hands off me. Quit shoving. I can walk on my own.
Maybe, but think how silly I'm going to look if you fall down. Come on.
Bloody arms are everywhere, haven't you?
Yeah, I just want to see you in one piece. We got a match to finish.
You're on.
If you haven't got your ID, I can't let you through.
Look, I'm sorry. I got an urgent phone call from Dr. Salter to fly over here from C Block. When he says now, he means now. You don't stop to think about bringing your handbag.
Yeah, that's all very well. But this is the high security section. I've got my responsibilities too, you know.
For goodness sake, get on the phone and call him. He'll tell you. I'm Meg Morris, counsellor with Corrective Services, and he was expecting me 5 minutes ago.
Yeah, well, you should have it with you.
Yeah, I know, but I haven't, and it's going to take me 10 minutes to go all the way back there, get up to the fourth floor and come back here again. He's going to want to know why. You know what senior medical staff are like about us meal workers.
Yeah, all right. But don't ask me to do this again.
Oh, thanks. Thanks a lot.
Hi. Come in.
Are you all right?
Yeah. It's like a holiday. I'm having a ball in this place.
Sorry, stupid question.
It's okay, at least I'm safe in here.
Yeah. That stuff about Rodney setting you up, was that true?
Yeah. You could have knocked me over when you told her. I reckoned it was Willis for sure.
That's what I thought.
How's, Marty?
Suspended. Both been charged.
Yeah, I know. Willis got to that bitch Maxwell too, didn't he?
He's been a busy bastard, all right. Mm. Well, at least if I hadn't known he was going to send someone round.
Look, that's okay. I just don't want you to think that I chickened out on you.
And Marty should never have gotten you into this.
Oh, what the heck? He didn't have a bloody clue. Could have got himself killed.
Yeah, but this is my mess and it's my problem. I don't want you dragged into it.
Too late now, eh?
No, you're out of it. We didn't mention you to the police or anything, so you just say nothing.
Thanks, Spike.
Enough people are dead because of me. I couldn't live with another one.
The year before that. Been chewing it over for ages. Seemed like a good time to get it on paper.
It's a lot of work.
Oh, I know. Part research, part wishful thinking.
Well, what are you going to do with it?
Before I do anything, I'd like you to take a look at it, see what you think.
Sure.
Come in. Oh, Dr. Lunn. We've been waiting for you.
Mrs. Reynolds, Mrs. Morris. I thought I'd better talk to you first before seeing Connors.
You got her test results?
Yes, we had them back yesterday.
I take it we've got a problem.
A rather big one, I'm afraid.
How big?
The worst it could be. She's in the advanced stages of the most lethal form of cancer.
But she's... I can't believe that. Well, what do we do next? What's the outlook for her?
Damned all. She's dying at 100 miles an hour.
Give me roses, I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain us too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. Comes around.